And from miles, when I got picked up at my hotel, I couldn't see the fire, but I can see the smoke. Y'all ain't saying nothing. And God is saying, just in case you're walking through so much where you done lost your way, I'm going to build a fire that's big enough for your spirit to recognize that I'm not giving up. I'm not giving in. I'm going to camp meeting. And when I get around the fire, the dominion power that's on the inside, it's going to be set on fire. Wait. Y'all, I'm going somewhere. I got to go, Jesus. Rush. I walked past the nurse. Take my time to say this. I went into the doctor. The other doctor came in. He looked at him. He took all my bandages off. He said, this ain't, all these stitches right here ain't supposed to be closed in a week. He said, all the rest of this stuff, you ain't supposed to be able to walk like this. I'm on my way out the doctor's office. And the receptionist says, you got the body of 5 people. And I said, no, baby, I don't have the body of 5 people, but I do have a 5-fold ministry that's on the inside, that's causing this body to come subject to the authority that's in the Word. Oh, my God, I'm talking about dominion. Dominion, Pastor Canton. And right now, some of y'all say you're getting a shot, pastors, evangelists. Well, what am I trying to say? What prophets by them, you don't know. Because when I came in camp meeting, I feel a little weak. I feel a little down. I feel like I'm going through. And I know when camp meeting over, I don't know what I'm going to do. And God took my mind back on my sick bed. He said, do you remember when I said to Elijah that he was going to perform 8 miracles? And do you remember somebody coming along named Elisha that was promised a double portion of that anointing? Do y'all remember that? Well, when I counted, Elisha had only performed 15 miracles, and 8 and 8 is 16. But God said one day, some bandits was passing by his grave and dropped a dead man in the grave. And God said, you better tell them people at camp meeting that when I give you dominion, you got it to the bone, baby. Oh, my God. It doesn't matter whether you look dead or alive. This thing will work when it ain't no skin there. It'll work when it ain't no blood there. It doesn't depend upon human resources to be power. Is that something? It does not depend on how hot the praise and worship singers is to be power. It does not. What am I doing right now? I'm freeing somebody that's in their house right now that's saying, I wish I had a winter camp meeting. I'm freeing somebody that's standing in here now that's saying, well, praising God like that is really not me. God is trying to give you an opportunity. Now watch this. What kind of opportunity? So I took myself, watch this, and I looked up. I had looked up that word, and I looked at the flyer, and the flyer said, Dominion Camp Meeting, and it was real pretty. Had the swords there. Then it said, Revolution. I said, okay, let me look at this thing again. Holy Ghost said, so you got to understand something. Got to understand something here. He said to revolute. Watch this dictionary. Watch this. To roll back on the undersurface from the tip of the margins as some leaves do before they are expanded. Let me break that down. So to revolute means to go in your spirit and go back from the first day that God saved you from the beginning and roll that thing back to the beginning. Now, why do you have to roll it back? Let me tell you why. Because it's like David and Goliath. See, the reason why the rock knocked him out is one of the natural reasons is you gotta put the rock in the slingshot and not throw it from where it is, but you gotta roll it back to its beginning margin. And when you let the rock go, it does damage. Now, maybe you've been through so much lately that you can't remember, so your testimony ain't got no power. Though the Bible said we overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the words of your testimony. I hear the Lord said, somebody need to roll all the way back and tell the devil, God did this, 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 God. Must I go on, Satan? Because if he did that, if he brought you, see, I gotta help some of y'all, because some of y'all in here dancing and shouting, and you done forgot you was crazy. You done forgot how your husband used to beat you up. You done forgot the days you didn't have nothing to eat. Come on here, somebody. I know you got a Neiman Marcus outfit now, and you got some bad shoes on, but you ain't always been like you are right now. You better let your mind go back to where God brought you from. Now, see, right there, you ought to praise God right there. Right there. Wait a minute. I'm not talking about no church praise. I ain't talking about no choir praise. You know what church praise is? Oh, hallelujah. Oh, yes, Father. Oh, Jesus. Hola bashala Messiah. That's a demon that don't want to mess up a suit. That's a devil that's full of pride. But you better frown up your ugly face and begin to give God some praise, because the song said, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, my soul cries out. I didn't say your voice cry out. Maybe I can help you with this. Stay right there. So, Pastor, I'm finished. Pastor, he said, so what is it? I done heard folks say, it's not a revolution. We in a revolution. But my dictionary say that a revolution is, watch this, y'all, an abrupt political overthrow or seizure of power brought from within the system. Wait. Watch this. So why is it that this year we doing it like this? Why are y'all here? Why the television camera is showing in people's houses? Because it has to be a collective decision of all parties involved that we ain't taking it no more. Watch this. Watch this. Watch this. Watch it. Watch. See, it ain't something you think about. It is abrupt. Okay, it's like this. It's you just going along in your day in the kitchen and all of a sudden say, wait a minute. And start looking around your house and say, I know the devil ain't in my house. Wait. Yeah, for the help you. See, because some of us, today God said, it's very prophetic that I'm here because the month of July is the seventh month and tonight is the ninth. But by the time you see this on television, God gonna be done already did what he said he was gonna do. So God said, tonight is my perfect number and I'm gonna birth you out to the point. Oh, y'all ain't gonna say nothing here. He said, I'm gonna get you to the point that, watch this, when a revolution hits, you don't say to yourself when you drive in your car, I can't wait till I get home because I feel something down in my spirit and I'm so sick of the devil. I'm tired of the devil. See, when there is a revolution, you start hollering where you at. Did somebody just get what I said? I said, did you just get what the Holy Ghost said? Yeah, huh? Your situation messed up, but God said, holler where you at. No, you ain't got every dime you need, but holler where you at. Oh, come on. Come on here, somebody. You ain't got everything you want, but start hollering where you at. I kept hearing the Holy Ghost say to me while I was recuperating, overthrow it. I said, phew. Something else will come up and God will say, overthrow it. And I said, what? God, I want you to work. He said, He said, you ain't got it. He said, sitting on the inside of you. See, that's why, Pastor Parsley, when you came before me twice yesterday, the Holy Ghost said, the warfare that he encounters is not because he's a pastor, because everybody building the church, because the Holy Ghost said this to me. He said, they have the form of my godly, watch this, they have the form of God, watch this, but they're denying the power thereof. He said, many have stolen my form, because my form can get you on TV. My form can help you build a church. My form can get some members in your church, but only my power can keep you. The reason why members don't stay, because you got the form, but you ain't got the power. So God said the warfare that you encounter is not because you are a pastor, but because you have chosen to stand in the gap and use this place as the meeting ground for anybody that's lacking dominion, for anybody that wants to start a revolution. If you standing in this building at night, the Holy Ghost said there is nothing in your life that you cannot tonight over. See nobody overthrowing nothing. Y'all too cute still. Honey, when you overthrow something, you run out of the place that you're in. You pick up your Bible, which is the sword of the Spirit, and you declare to the devil that no weapon that's formed against me, it's going to prosper. For the weapons of my warfare, they are not carnal, but they're mighty. You don't believe me? No. You don't believe that. You don't believe it. Watch this. Watch what I stumbled across. Why is it right now that I don't feel no pain? Nope. Y'all ain't saying nothing. See, y'all ain't saying nothing. Somebody said, well, the Lord done healed her. And he done gave her a miracle 2 weeks after into the surgery. One part, section of my body split open. And the doctor said, we can't close it because, he said, there's something foreign that is in there. And he said, the body ain't gonna shut up until the foreign thing comes out. Ooh. The doctor said, what you looking for is beauty. He said, but I'm looking for purification. Y'all ain't gonna like this tonight. And God is saying, what some of y'all pastors are looking for is to be able to say, yeah, doc, see the church I done built? That's where we are. You looking for beauty. But God said, I ain't gonna let that thing come together until I get purification. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing in here. Some of y'all wondering why your ministry ain't coming forth, because God said, you looking for beauty, and I'm looking for purification. And as long as there's no purification, there shall not be any beauty. And anytime they look at you, they'll see your open sore. Watch this. Y'all ain't saying it. Watch this. Watch this. Watch this. What is my open sore? When they don't call your name for stuff and you go home mad, God said, there it is. He said, your stitches done bust open. Yeah, why didn't they recognize me? Why I see my guy can't get nobody come and help me out? I'm trying to build this church and I only need $1 more million. Why I seem like the folk won't give? Why I seem like they won't help me? Why I seem like, because God is saying, if they help you, they'll own you. He said, if they assist you, they will control you. He said, but I'm gonna leave you with this thing open. Watch this, y'all. Now, I don't know what he's telling you, but this is what he told me. He said, your doctor ain't gonna get all the glory. He said, but there's a part of you I got to leave open. So when I shut it, you'll be able to look at that thing and say, it wasn't my doctor. It wasn't the anesthesia. It wasn't the herbs that I was taking. But it was dominion and power that stepped out of my belly and shut this thing up. So I didn't understand, y'all, why the Lord said, go to camp meeting anyway. I said, what? I said, what you saying? He said, I said, go to camp meeting anyway, because there's a whole lot of people walking around with an open sore. You come on, y'all ain't saying nothing. He said, you're going to stand in the building proxy for every open sore that won't close, for every hurt and for every pain that you can't seem to get over. The Holy Ghost said, smarten up and look up here at me, because there's another scripture that said that they were healed as they went. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Some of y'all won't step out and obey God because you said, ain't got enough friends, ain't got enough support, ain't got enough money, ain't got enough time, ain't got enough this. And God said, I'm the one that causes the shortage, because I want your expansion to be in me. I want you to learn how to lean lean and depend on my everlasting arm. I want you to understand that it's not by power nor by might, but it's by my spirit.
Oh, watch this. Ooh. You're getting ready to get a miracle. He said, what did I say in my, watch this, y'all, watch this. He said, the book of Revelation was written, watch this, to reveal the happenings, the mysteries, the goings-ons of what God is going to do. See, y'all got to understand this. Elisha, they got in the battle over there, and the king said, I'm killing somebody, because y'all in here, every time we set ambush, these folk keep finding out what my plan is. And can I just paraphrase that? He said, we ain't telling nothing. He said, there's a man over there walking in dominion. He said, and when he go to God, God keep telling him all of your secrets. Did y'all get what I'm trying to say tonight? Do you hear the Holy Ghost? You ain't got a plan and you ain't got to figure that out. He said, what you got on the inside of you is a voice that anything that you need to know, when you get in your secret time with me, there is a man that's on the inside of you that'll tell you anything that you want to know. And he didn't stop there. He said, what are we gonna do? And he told his little servant, the servant said, they done went and got everybody against us. And we surrounded. I'm feeling somebody. He said, we surrounded. We can't go nowhere. We surround. Watch this. I want you to look at how I illustrate this. The little boy come running and say, we messed up. We surrounded everybody. Everybody is against us. And Elisha goes out. He said, oh, we got more than they do. And he said, so this kid looks at him and says, you off? He said, we're surrounded. And he said, God, help this immature, spiritually immature child to see what I see. When the boy looked out there again, he said, you know what? It'd be more. See, let me help y'all with something. God said to me about 8 months ago, he said, in the realm of the flesh, the devil operates because I've allowed him victory in the realm of the flesh. He said, so anytime my believers go in the flesh to resolve anything, they're going to lose, because the devil has the victory in the flesh realm, but he ain't got the victory in the spirit realm. And he said, the reason why you can't see your way out, because you're living too low. You're praying too low. You're walking too low. You got to get yourself up in a realm, and so you can see your deliverance coming when everybody think you're going to die, and everybody think you're not going to make it, and everybody think you're going under. When they look at you, you say, there be more with me. Then with them, and when I said, Lord, what shall I do for Dominion Camp Meeting? He said, turn. He said, you remember that little scripture that we used to quote in Sunday school? We quote all the time. It says, now unto him. That is, God help somebody to receive this. People of God, not tomorrow. People in television land, not tomorrow. Now unto him who is able to keep you from falling. Let me just bring this in. Why is he going, not you? Okay. Not you, but you. You don't want to do right, but you do. The you that's it. Watch this. Watch this here now. Because see, watch this. If God just start going around just keeping me by, oh, God, keep me. Oh, God, keep me. Then the day you meet it, tomorrow you don't. Oh, God, get me out. One day you meet it, one day you don't. But see, what happens is when you put his word on the inside of your spirit, what he keeping is his word. Y'all ain't saying nothing right there. He may look at your life and say, she makes me sick, but she done got my word down in her, and I promise that neither one dot or tittle of my word is going to pass. I said heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall forever stand. I got to keep my word. I may not like her attitude, but I got to keep my word. Now, when, saints, now. Okay, please get this. When? Well, Prophet Bynum, you don't know what my life is like right now. I don't care. God just said now. Okay, let me just bring this closer to you. You have just been changed. I think y'all got me mixed up with an evangelist. I just prophesied. I think y'all think I'm just a teacher tonight, but I'm coming in the office of a prophet. I'm gonna say it again. The Holy Ghost said, you have just been changed. Your church have just been changed. Your marriage have just been changed. Now! You better get that and start running. Somebody better get that and start jumping it. I said now. No, it ain't a music thing tonight. It ain't a piano thing. It ain't an organ thing. It's a dominion thing. You better start shouting because God said now, 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 now. Something is going out over the television right now. Something is going out in the radio land right now. It's in your living room right now. It's on your couch right now. Somebody begin to shout in this place. God said, I'm doing it now. Let me finish this. And to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with more than enough joy. More than enough joy. Why I don't feel no pain? Because he's doing it now. I didn't take no painkillers before I walked in here. I took a dominion killer. But watch this. Now, I got this right here. This right here is your home stretch. Because this right here took me into a realm that I saw stuff that I've been waiting on. Watch this. I saw it happen. See, let me just help you with something. I'm looking at it right now. In this place right now, I'm looking at stuff over y'all lives and over the lives of people that are watching on TBN, and stuff is happening. You don't believe what I just said? You want me to prove it? Well, why I got to holler like that? Why it don't make no sense? Why I got to praise God like that? Well, why I got to jump? Well, who said I got to jump? The Bible told me that David was on the backside of the desert, and he was praising God and worshiping God, and Samuel was got Saul, stripping the anointing off of Saul and getting David ready. I want to ask you something. What is it that God is doing for you right now that you don't know God is doing? And what God is saying, if you just start praising me and stop trying to figure me out, he said, I already got your end fixed. Hey, baby, it's a fixed fight. He didn't bring you in here to give you dominion. He brought you in here to remind you that you already got dominion. But he's saying you better use it and you better overthrow the enemy. I'm through. Watch this. To the only wise God, my rescuer. Be glory and majesty. Now, I don't know how you can stand there in your pew when I say this next word, because you better tell your neighbor, baby, excuse me this next time. I got to get out of this role because I got to, oh, don't worry about me, honey, I'm working on something. I know I may get a little loud in a few minutes, but I just found out that he is glory and majesty and dominion. Now, you better praise God right now. You don't hear what he's saying. He said, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now, 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 now. But now, 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 the Holy Ghost said, now, now, now. Now! 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 It's a revolution. It's a revolution. It's a revolution. Turn around and tell somebody. Now that's dominion. Now shout this. Now say it's a revolution. Well then overthrow it, overthrow it, overthrow it. Overthrow it. Overthrow it. Overthrow it. Overthrow it. Overthrow it. Overthrow that sickness. I'm talking to somebody in television land. Overthrow that poverty. The power is in you tonight. And God said one more time, I never dare somebody to give God a sacrifice praise. Oh, honey, do something that you ain't never done before. When you do something that you ain't never done before, that's a revolution. Come on, shout, say it. Yes, yes. Let me tell you when you got dominion. Because when the music stops, that don't stop your praise. Say it. When the piano stops, when the drums stop, I can still praise her. When the organ stop, I can still praise her. Because I got dominion, 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 both now. Jesus. It said, Shalabasando. He da 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 da. Y'all ain't saying that. The devil should have killed me. He should have never let y'all get here. Not this year. He should have never let you get here. But now that you're here, jelly pack, but you're going home with power and dominion forever. See ya. Oh. See, let me help you with something. I got to go. Let me tell you something. See, when you walk, in dominion, you don't come to church walking like this. You come to church with a walk that says, I just got set up for a miracle. Because I don't know what kind of Bible y'all read, but I read the word when it said, that Bible said that them children of Israel, it said the more that they oppressed them, they multiplied. So I'm trying to change your attitude tonight by telling you, instead of saying, Satan, Lord, rebuke you, I bind you right now, tell the devil, make my day. Ha! Because every time you put your hands on me, I multiply in the Holy Ghost. Say it! So what am I trying to say? I'm gonna leave you with this. Wherever the devil, whatever and wherever the enemy has got his hands in your life, that's getting ready to multiply. Now that's a revolution. You ain't got to wonder what God is getting ready to do next. Check the trouble. And wherever the trouble is, that's where multiplication is going to start. When the devil touched the son that came out of your loins, now here come many sons. Now there shall be a quadrupling in the birthing that you're going to do. When you open up your mouth and say, y'all ain't saying nothing. And God, I can't even get this thing out. See, wherever your prophet's back, you don't know the devil is touching my marriage. And you getting ready to have a honeymoon. Now that's dominion. The devil is touching my job. You getting ready to get another job. Now that's dominion. Can I get somebody to shout in here? The devil is touching my ministry. Well, you're getting ready to get a bigger ministry and a more anointed ministry. Now that's dominion. God, listen to this. As I walk off this platform, watch this. God told me to tell you that when the thing hits an area, press in to that area. Get it? When the enemy comes messing with your family. Some of y'all saying, well, I don't know what to do. Come out of that secret closet and go on in that kitchen like my mama used to do. And as soon as we sit down and get ready to eat, mother fix the table and all five of us would sit down. At that time, I was getting high. We were just going crazy. And mother would go to that kitchen table and lay the table out and bring all the food on the table and just start hollering, hallelujah! I'm not lying. She started going, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. What is she doing? She's taking back from the devil. She's telling the enemy, though you got your hands in here, you got a battle on your hands. Cause I'm gonna, y'all ain't saying nothing. I'm gonna praise God until I shake your foundation. Mm-hmm. See, they think you're crazy on your job anyway. you might as well go and take that trip to the bathroom and get in that stall. See, when you do that kind of stuff, what you tell the devil, I own this ground, not you, not you, not you, not you. I'm in authority. Everybody, watch this. You got people in this place tonight. I was in the back. Enemy said, you ain't gonna be able to preach. You sick. I said, my spirit ain't devil. Watch this. And since I don't preach in the flesh, I won't be needing the flesh. Since you don't live in the flesh, you won't be needing the flesh. Since you don't give in the flesh, you won't be needing the flesh. As I close tonight, let me tell y'all something. He said, every time you see this video, every time your mind go back to the night, he said, he's letting you know, I got you. You ain't got to tell me. As a matter of fact, stop telling me. I already know. Well, God, why you ain't fixed it? He said, I already did. I'm just waiting for you to seize it. Now watch this right here. When I start sitting back then, I heard Pastor Parsley out here talking. He was talking about the raven and all that, and he was ministering. Some of y'all sit out here, but watch this. Let me tell you something. Ministry. Oh, let me tell you something. You in this meeting, and this is the last night, and dominion doesn't start operating in the beginning. Because all y'all praise and worship leaders, all the choir, first night of camp meeting, we're gonna praise in the Lord. But everybody got no bit. Oh, y'all was mad. Till them last nights start coming, their voice start giving out. Then you had to start singing with dominion. Everybody in here will go, hey. Until the Holy Ghost said last night, give me a praise, because what you don't understand is when you walk from out of the camp meeting, you got to get close enough to the fire for your neighbors to smell the smoke. See, you ain't going to have to go back to your church past this time. Let me tell y'all what God did for me. And I'm telling you, it's going to be some change around here. And missionary, Sophia home, that thing going to change around here. How do we get in this place? You're going to walk in your pulpit when you get back home. And they're going to say, y'all smell something? You smell something. And see, one thing about smoke, when you're in it long enough, you don't realize you smell like smoke. And so they're going to say, you smell something. You're going to say, I don't smell nothing. But every now and then, they're going to hear one of these come out of you. How? They're going to say, what happened to you? You're going to say, camp meeting, baby. Camp meeting. Camp meeting. Dominion. How did you finish building your church with less people than you started with? how did your ministry take off to where it is, dominion? And God, watch this. Listen to this. When Pastor Parsley was talking about the raven, God in that back room said to me, he said, listen. He said, there are some people, oh, Pastor Kayton. He said, there are some people that are in this building. Pastor Kayton, you're one of those people. That's why I just said, ooh. He said, there are some people in this building tonight that God, when he gave me that word that said in the month of July, he said, it's a divided line. He said, everywhere you go, tell them, choose. He said, because the split is going to take place in July. And he said, everything that ain't on my side is going down. He told me that in prayer. He told me that in prayer. He said, tell the church. Oh, y'all keep on sliding. Everything that ain't on my side. I told you I ain't scared. I'm a prophet. I said, keep on humping and all that stuff and thinking that all that messes God. And he took me to Ecclesiastes 10. He said, a fly done got in the oil of the apothecary. He said, everybody, they better make up in their mind, because in the month of July, a split is coming. And he said, everything that's not on my side and everything that's not calling on my name without the spirit of compromise in it, it's going down. He said, I'm getting ready to pay for compromise. He said, tell him, in the month of July. He said, what do you mean, God? He said, because people that are on my side, they don't walk in the flesh. They don't operate in the flesh. He said, there are pastors and people that are studying in this building right now. Pastor probably says this out. He said, there's some people in this building right now. You ought to just stretch forth and you ought to come on. You ought to do this. And some of y'all can get $20. Some of y'all can give $100. Some of y'all can even give $1,000. God, and I heard the Holy Ghost back there said, this is the last night, he said, but this is what I'm saying. I ain't saying to you, he said, when you stand on the floor as a prophet, he said, I'm not saying to you to say to them. I'm not saying to you to say to them. And some of y'all can get what is. Some of y'all can get. Some of y'all can get. He said, you talk like that when you talking to some church people, some believers, some dominion people. And then God said to me, I want my people out of this crowd tonight. He said, I want my dominion people to come from out of the congregation of the dead. I want, phew, some of y'all shouting tonight, dead as a doornail. He said, I want to pull my people of dominion out from the crowd. He says, because the church shouts, but those that are in dominion obeys. There's a difference. He said, the church dance, but this next grade is for dominion people. It's for people, my sister, who can look right at their checking account and say, this is my last, but I can get this again. Because I walk in dominion, and he said, that power cannot be proven until it's your last. He said, he that hungers, watch this, he that hungers and thirsts after righteousness shall be filled. He don't feel full, people. He don't My staff said to me all the time, why do you do that, prophets? Why do you get down to, why do you always do, why do you always, we go somewhere and see, whenever I'm believing God for a project, I see, I tell people that work around me, I said, I haven't hired hirelings. I have embraced people who walk in the spirit, because I told them, I said, I walk in the office any day, whenever God tell me. I said, hello, I just want to make an announcement. Ain't nobody getting paid today, because God just told me to take all the money we got and send it to so-and-so at his church. And they be looking like this. I said, well, quit. Quit. Because I can put an ad in the newspaper and hire some people. But I want power. I want somebody who's able to see the cupboard empty and know there's a resource. I want somebody that can walk with me. I don't need nobody getting high because you're walking with somebody that's well known. I want somebody that can get down to the last bottom of the barrel and say to me, prophetess, God still is a way maker. Do what God says. Now that's dominion. What happened, Tanya, every time we do it? God triple, God dripple, God lopper, lipple, the whatever word you can think of. I mean, the windows of heaven just open up because, now watch this, because God keep telling me. He said, everything I've ever done in your life, when I was driving a chugger bug, he said, get out of the way and walk. And I get out of the way and walked. Then God said, he blessed me with the Toyota Camry, and brand new. He said, now, in a year and a half, he said, pay that off and give it to this lady in the church and walk. Everybody in my church says, she just so stupid. God ain't telling. She just so spiritual. And God ain't telling. That's just so stupid. And I said to God, walking down the street with tears in my eyes, I said, why would you tell me to give my car away and I ain't got a car? He said, because I'm trying to show you that many cars are in you. I'm trying to show you that you can give away anything and get it again. You just, because it's in you. It ain't in your checking account. It's in you. See, y'all don't want to get happy right there. I say, because see, your comfort level is what your balance say. My comfort level is what God says. I said, that's all right, Lord. Walked into the Mercedes dealership, slapped my hand down on a 300 SC, bought the car. A year and a half later, God said, go to the bank, pay it off, give it to that lady in the church, and walk. Paid it off. Gave it to the lady in the church and walked. And the Holy Ghost said, now go pay cash for your limousine. So and God already talking to me saying, this ain't your level. I'm taking you all the way to your grade. He said, now, the reason why I want you to pay cash for it, because you're going to give it to somebody. Because you got to sow it, because I keep trying to tell you, you can get anything you want in you. It ain't in, see, come on somebody. See, a lot of us do this. We give it because we see what's over here. And God said, that ain't dominion until you give it and ain't got nothing left. That's dominion. That's rulership from another grade. Now watch this. 5 seconds ago. Now right now they said, well, just play some music or something. See, it ain't a note on that piano that can put a yes, Lord, in a person's spirit when it ain't already in there. Obedience ain't in the piano. God spoke to me. He said, there are people in this building tonight. He said, this month, I'm giving you financial dominion. Because I said, listen to this. Men of God, women of God, you better snuggle up next to your husband and say, babe, get that checkbook out. Because you got to understand something. When God sends a prophet and tell me to say it, I'm just going to say it. He said, what Pastor Prosty said today wasn't just matter of factish. He said, now you down to the last. He said, God told me, he said, there are many people in this building tonight. He said, walk in dominion. He said, there are many of you in this building tonight. God said, now, when you write the check for $1,000, I'm going to give you dominion in the area of finances that won't cease. Somebody better start moving right now, because I feel something. I ain't the storyteller. I'm not the kind of, well, let me tell you why you should. The Bible said, my sheep know my voice, and a stranger they won't follow. And the Holy Ghost said, come right now, because it's not dominion until it hurts. It's not dominion until you have to do it bent over. See, let me help you with something. This ain't offering, because offering says give cheerfully. Dominion says, I don't want to do this. This is not what I feel. This is hurting me. It's a sacrifice. It's pain. And I'm not happy about it. But I'm going through a transition, because I'm walking. God, let your people believe it. You're walking out of the natural realm of what you're used to in your finances into something else. God said, come right now. See, because you already know who you are. I ain't got to say, hey, two more people. God. He said now. You can't. He said it's a revolution. He said it's a revolution. Okay, I said he said it's a revolution. That means abruptly. That means ain't no thought pattern. I'm not saying I think I gotta think about it. Run from wherever you are, because I feel something in this place. He said this month, this Pastor Carrington, I feel that thing on you tonight. See, because the reason why I'm not gonna let him play no music, because ain't no piano in the car. Let me tell you something. I ain't never seen no Hammond B3 in the mortgage company. Never. Hello, somebody. I ain't never heard nobody play the piano while they show you blueprints to a new building that you getting ready to build. So God said, get that thing out your spirit that says, I gotta have some music. You don't need music. You need an ear to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. God, get me to do something here. You better tell your husband, that's us. I tell your wife, she talking to us. The church ain't finished being built. That's why it's us. I'm saving for a new car. That's why it's you. And the walls, Darlene Bishop, shall not be able to contain them. You ain't seen nothing yet. Big stuff. Woo. Big stuff. Big stuff. Ain't never gave no $1,000 before. Well, you got to do something you ain't never did in order to get something you ain't never had. Mm-hmm. Yeah, somebody, that's dominion. Mm-hmm. It's this month. It's this month that you go underneath and roll back to the margin point. It's this month that you overthrow it. Well, do you think we should do this? Are you asking? Mm-mm. You grabbing your stomach and you in severe pain all the way to the altar. See, y'all ain't gonna say nothing right here, because I'm gonna tell you what's getting ready to happen. Everybody all over this building, anybody in this building that's got $100 anywhere on them, that's dominion. Start walking. Start walking. Start walking. Mm-hmm. start walking. And watch this. And see, when it's a sacrifice to you, that's birthing. When you can come and say, when I give, it come back. When I, when it's hurting, that's travail. That means I'm sowing a seed for something. Something is going to be birthed out of this. Oh God. Everybody all over this building. If I was you tonight, I would come as close as I can. If I got $36.17, the Holy Ghost said, don't walk down here unless it's a hurting offering. You can walk down here and give God $100 and don't feel it. You ain't sacrificed nothing. You can walk down here and give God $10 and you don't feel it. You ain't gave nothing. There ain't no sacrifice. Sacrifice says, this hurt me. I really didn't mean to do this. He said, but it's the last night after you done gave all week. He said, now, this is dominion. Something just happened right now. See, sometimes I say things while people giving like this, and I think people think I just be saying stuff while people walking. Did you hear what just came out of my mouth? I said, something just happened. Well, maybe some of y'all is grieving too hard over to. If I can just get 100 people to grab a hold to what just came out of my mouth, there will be a financial revolution in this building. So I'll say it again, something just happened. When I feel it, and see, some of y'all, when I say that, I keep hearing some of y'all praise God, and then you stop. I don't think you understand what the Holy Ghost is saying. Something in the area of what you've been believing God for, in the area of money, it just happened. Okay, I'm going to say it one more time. If what, now some of y'all going to think I'm crazy, but I'm going to say it anyhow. If what you are believing God for, you need keys to get in it, go in your purse and take out some keys and act like you getting in a car. Act like you walking in a living room, because God said it just happened. God, if I could get somebody, just keep praising it. You better shake them keys. Honey, ain't no evangelist, I'm a prophet. You better shake them like they new keys. Oh, come on here, pastor. You better shake it like it's the key to your new church. You better shake it like it's the key to your new house. Your neighbor think you crazy. I know they saying you so stupid. Why you shaking them keys like that? What is that supposed to mean? Turn around and tell them, baby, you just don't know. But the Bible said, if I believe the prophet, so shall I prosper. And the woman of God said, it just happened. We'll be right back. count to three, people said, I got it in the spirit. I got it now. I got it right now. I got it right now. Turn around and tell somebody, I got it right now. Come on, tell somebody else, I got it. I got it. I got it. I can sense it. I can feel it. I can smell it. I got it. Right now, because you got it. You better praise the name of the Lord. I got it. Come on, here, something getting ready to erupt in this place. Come on, something getting ready to erupt in this place. It's got something to do with money. A revolution. A revolution. The Lord said, overthrow poverty right now. Overthrow it with a shout. Scared to praise God for money. Money comes with dominion. Money comes with dominion. I never dare somebody to start praising God for money. It's a revolution. The reason why you're praising God, because you're overthrowing poverty. You're overthrowing depression. You're overthrowing the spirit of lack. Shout! Yes! Yes! Sound the trumpet in Zion. Overthrow it!
Microphone back to Pastor Parsley now. But before I leave the platform, the Lord just told me to tell you to do something. And this is prophetic, so don't miss this. Last night, the last night of camp meeting, you can't miss this. Because an actual change like this is getting ready to happen in your, watch this, in the way you operate. The Holy Ghost said he's anointing the mouth of every individual in this place. Watch this, watch this, watch this. And he said, you turn to your neighbor, whether it's your wife, whether it's your friend, whether it's your pastor, whether you know him or not. And he said, under the anointing, these words are going to follow them for years to come. He said, look them in their eyes and point your finger. And when I count to three, he said, shout it to them. I'm not talking about... He said, shout it to their face, you've got dominion. Oh!
Stretch your hand toward this servant of God. Stretch your hand toward that servant of God. Those of you that are coming, don't you miss this. Don't you miss that word. You keep coming. Ushers, let them through. You keep coming. You keep coming. Nobody gets left out. Not on the last night. Nobody gets left out. Your seed is important to your harvest. You keep coming. This precious woman of God, cut from hip to hip 3 weeks ago. Most of you can't get over a cold in 3 weeks. And she held nothing back from you. Nothing. Now you stretch your hands toward her. She operated under a high anointing. And everybody always says, yeah, but when she gets back there and the anointing lifts off of her, then it'll hit her. No, it won't. No, it won't. No, it won't. You speak that dominion life that's in her and in you to resurrect in her. Speak it. I want her to hear it in the back of the building. I want her spirit to hear it. I want her spirit to hear it. Shout dominion! 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 Now praise him that it's alive on her right now. It's alive in her right now. It's alive in her right now. It's alive in her right now. Right now. Right now. Right now. It's alive. It's alive. It's alive. It's alive. Listen to me. Listen to me. Keep coming. Joni, wait. Shepherd woman. Come touch this woman right here. Come touch. God just told me he's going to give her a financial miracle in 15 days. Touch her. Touch her. Right there. Right there. Come here, Joni. Keep coming. Some people looked at me.
Pastor Parsley, a man of his stature, get down and roll on the floor.
I turn flip-flops. I don't have no dignity. What do I want to have dignity for? I roll again. I rolled, you didn't. I'm holding my miracle. I roll again. The number one thing that my son has been frightened of, another one of those imprints, is anytime there are clouds, and if it rains, he goes and goes upstairs and gets under the bed and pulls all the covers up over him and sits in there and shakes and sweats and cries. He's done it since he was 2 years old. He'll watch the Weather Channel, and if a storm's coming 3 days from now, that fear grips him. You didn't know it, but we've been having next to tornadoes outside. I said next to because we've been having one in here. I didn't know it about 15 minutes ago. They said, the storms have gotten really ugly. So I turned to one of our assistants. I said, you go now. Go now and check on my baby. Because I tell you, I'd leave you in a heartbeat. Go help my baby. My baby means more to me than you. I love you, but I got to tell you, he means more than you do. The storm was really ugly. Austin did what he always does, ran and hid under the bed and under the blankets for 15 minutes. But suddenly, some of you are going to get some suddenly. In fact, when you get back to the hotel, there's going to be a message light on your phone. Dial it, dial it, dial it. There's a miracle waiting. You can laugh at me, call me stupid, call me, I don't care what you call me. You couldn't give me a miracle. You ain't that bad. God told me, if you want your son delivered, this is before I knew any of this, said, if you want your son delivered, prove to me you're not too proud to worship me. He said, the next time that anointing jumps off her and jumps on you, roll! Well, I don't care. If he tells me to bray like a donkey, get out of my way. I don't care what you think about me. Well, a man of his stature. I don't got no stature. Don't want no stature. Don't want no clout with you. Not trying to impress you. Or you. In the height of the lightning and thunder, my boy just popped his head. He picked up two books and said, I want to read. This is the boy that said he'd never read, never go to school, never know I was his daddy. But then when God says roll, I roll. What do you want to read, Austin? I want to read Helpful Hal's Treasury of Christian Virtues. Most of you couldn't read it. He announced to his caregiver, she said he looked up with the thunder and the lightning and looked around and announced, quote, I am never going to be afraid of storms again. Run, Darlene, run! Run! God will set your children free if you run. He'll set them free. then read his story, told his caregiver it's time to pray, prayed his prayer, laid his head on her shoulder, sang a chorus of Silent Night with the thunder rolling, Silent Night with the rain falling, Silent Night. Looked up at his caregiver, gave her a kiss, and politely fell asleep. They traced it to exactly the time I was rolling in the presence of the Lord. Do you want a revolution or not? Do you want a revolution or not? I dare you to praise him like you ain't ever praised him. Dominion is in me. Nah. Oh, come on, you got one more praise. You know you got one. If you got a child needs deliverance, I dare you to praise him.
Been without pain in the bottom of my feet for 4.5 months, and tonight it's all gone.
Jump up and shout and rejoice in the Lord. Every
jump.
Jump up and shout and soar.
I got a hold of him at 3:30 in the afternoon. I love you so much. Thank you. What a tremendous time we've had. You need to take it home with you. Tonight's service alone. How do they do that, Sheila? They can they take videos home with them tonight of tonight? They can? In this foyer? This way? This way? All three? All three, Charlie? Here. Anyway, just look around till you find them. Fresh video. I don't mean to keep walking away from you, honey. Fresh video. And you can take all the videos home with you. You can take, can they take the audios home with them? They can take all the audios home with them. Would you thank Marcus and Joni Lamb, who this week have carried Dominion Camp Meeting across the nation live by television? Would you thank them? How many souls have been touched? We rejoice. And Paul and Jan Crouch, we thank them for carrying it on the Trinity Broadcasting Network. And by the internet around the world, 16 million hits we got on the internet, visits to our website. 16 million. Think of that. Isn't that something? Those of you who have felt the tug of God on your heart concerning World Harvest Bible College, this is what you're... Do you know that all the speakers that spoke this week speak in World Harvest Bible College? To the students at World Harvest Bible College. Now that's the kind of ministry you get for 9 solid months. You can live on this property in beautiful dormitories. What on earth kind of person would you be when you left here? You'd be a giant killer. You need to come. Pastors' Conference is a few weeks away. September 23rd. 3 days you get to hang out with us. Seminars all day, and I preach 2 or 3 times a day. We have a glorious time. We're coming to Birmingham, Alabama. We're coming to Charlotte, North Carolina, to Huntington, West Virginia. We're coming. So you look for us. We love you so much. Thank you. If I don't see you at a meeting, if I don't see you on Breakthrough, all children who were in the tents should be picked up in the Ministry Activity Center building. That's this big, huge 133,000 square foot building out there. And when you walk through it, thank God that everything you see is paid for, and ask God to finish it. But there in the Ministry Activity Center, due to the storm, and you go through D Wing, you go right this direction. Everybody look at me if your children are out there. You go right this direction. If you don't, see one of the greatest ushers on the planet, and they will direct you. So if I don't see you on Breakthrough in a meeting, I'll see you at the finish line. God bless you. We love you. Thank you.